浪明星会独家专访克里斯蒂安·贝尔。从太阳帝国到金陵十三钗，贝尔的中国之旅有收获。
Amazing,
nail be。这个也学会了。
神父与风尘女子上演激情戏，贝尔现身只为剧情。
Of course, I'll do that because enhancing the story is not gratuitous。
携手新任谋女郎，贝尔对新搭档有话说。
As good as anybody that I've ever worked with.And also newcomers creating themselves constantly. They have no particular technique that they're falling back on. And I think that's a wonderful thing.
金陵十三钗强势来袭，幕后精彩等你来揭秘。
各位新浪朋友们，大家下午好，欢迎收看新浪直播间。那么现在呢，我们正在外面，因为坐在旁边的呢，我们要跟他见面的是大家非常非常熟悉的好莱坞影星，那他也是刚刚过去的奥斯卡的最佳男配角，让我们一起欢迎克里斯蒂安·贝尔。 Welcome Christian Bale.
Thank you.
How are you today?
Great.
今天觉得还不错。So is this your first time in China?
No. I was here first in 1987, and then I was here early this year for 2.5 months filming. And then a few trips to Hong Kong, and then this is the most recent.
I read some news, and they're saying that is the director Steven Spielberg has wrote a letter to you saying that you really should act in Emo Chan's film. Is that right?
Emo brought me a letter.I believe Emo and Steven are friends. And yes, Steven sent me a note saying he hopes that we can do this and how much he respects Emo.
因为之前我看到一些新闻说是非常著名的好莱坞导演斯皮尔伯格导演有写一封信给贝尔先生，要他一定要演出张导的戏。那刚刚他也跟我们解释了这里面有一个这样的一个过程，是因为这样的契机才使你加入到这个剧组当中吗？是因为这一封信，还是你自己有什么缘由？ So that's what brought you to this crew, this film?
No, I had already made up my mind. I like Emo's movies very much. I think he's a very fine storyteller. And so my creative decision had already been made. I think in many ways probably it helped Emo to make the decision, more so than myself.
之前看过的 Emo 导演的戏，刚刚他也说挺喜欢的，不知道哪一部他现在还记得是他非常偏爱的。So which other Emo's film do you like the best?
Well, I think often, you know, the first movie that you see often sticks with you the most. And when I was 17 years old, I saw Raise the Red Lantern at a film festival in the United States. And I believe that I also saw Emo. I'm not entirely sure that that's correct, but I thought that I did actually see Emo at that time. So that one had always stuck with me.
When you're really working with him, how do you like him?
I liked him a great deal. Emo has a very good sense of humor.And he has a very loyal crew who like him a great deal. He's a wonderful storyteller. I quite enjoyed the fact that whilst we were able to communicate, and Emo's daughter, Momo, did a wonderful job translating, there were certain nuances that we were unable to really, they got lost in translation.Which I would sometimes be able to enjoy with English-speaking directors, but not always, you know. There's often an absolute communication breakdown with English directors. In fact, I would say that in many ways I communicated better with Emo than I have with numerous English-speaking directors that I've worked with before. But because there were times when we couldn't go into absolute nuance, it became more of a show and tell. And so I would just show...Emo, what I was talking about. And I enjoy that immensely. I think that far often on movie sets, there's too much talking, and it's unnecessary. And many actors use talking as a device to avoid actually doing something. And I'm the opposite. I like to do it. So I gave him very many variants of a take, and that's the way that I enjoy working. So that he can then go and choose. And he has creation ability in the editing.
确实在如果你跟外国人交流有障碍的时候，最好的方式就是用你的 body language， 用你的身体语言。那我觉得做演员很好的一点是他们可以直接用演的就告诉你，你可以选哪个。 I'm just telling the audience that the best way to get everybody understand what you are meaning in any language is the body language、mm. you can just act。 所以我想问他，跟张导这一次在拍戏的过程当中，张导是一个怎么样的导演？他会告诉你要什么样的戏，还是说他给你更多的尊重让你自己去诠释？ I'm just asking Emil, will he tell you what he wants, or he just give you space that you can, you know, act free?
He would usually let me act free, as you call it, and then tell me what he wants. So because sometimes you'd find that was all that he wanted,、mm-hmm. and so he realized there was nothing to say, and other times that he felt there was something that I wasn't seeing, and that he wanted me to try.、
Mm-hmm. 这样是跟西方的一些导演有所区别吗？还是大多数西方的导演，好莱坞导演也是这样的？ So is it like the same way Western directors or the Hollywood directors do, or do they differ in any kind?
Everybody differs.No director ever works with another director. So they all create their own style、mm-hmm. of working. So every single movie,regardless of whether it be Emo or any other director who I've worked with before, you have to learn their style. So to me, there's not much difference between working with Emo and working with an American director.
但是我想每一个环境团队可能也是会有很大的不同，比如说之前我们了解到的好莱坞在拍摄的环境可能会比较舒服，比如说演员可能有自己很大的一辆休息车等等，那也许在中国的环境是不具备的，尤其在拍这种战争题材的时候。所以要问一下贝尔先生，这一次觉得中国的团队有没有什么不一样的地方？We always heard that in Hollywood film crew, they have big cars, truck, you know, those touring cars, and actors or the actress can rest in it. But in Chinese film crew, it's not like that doesn't happen in any crew. And especially this one is war, it's a war film. So do you think the Chinese film crew like is very different from any other Western?
Well,You tend to get the large trailers and everything, the luxurious accommodations that you're talking about, with very big movie stars who may have somewhat of an ego, and also with very large budget movies. Mm. With independent movies, you don't get that at all.
Right.
I've been on movies where there are no trailers whatsoever, and you just, you know, lay on the ground in between.Takes. So it changes. Everything changes depending on what style of movie, what director you're working with, and what budget you're dealing with.
我们一直听说这一部《金陵十三钗》在拍摄的环境相对是比较艰苦的，因为有很多战争场面，所以会有泥土啊、尘埃啊、血浆啊等等，有很多。那我是有这样的一个消息，是说里面的有一部分演员，他们为了可以不在艰苦的环境下面去上洗手间，所以会少喝一点水，这样就可以不用一直去跑那个环境很艰苦的洗手间。想问一下贝尔先生，是不是也是这样？